Hi, good evening, Altrincham. How are you? Good evening, Kate.
Hello. Good evening, Andy.
How are you?
I'm all right. I've had a bit of car trouble today.
Car trouble?
Yes. And I'm going to just give a mention to Manor Garages. Are they on Washway Road? Well, they're next to the Evan Holshaw Garage. I actually got my car from there, and they just said, bring the car back in, we'll plug it up to the computer and we'll look at it. They did that for free. So I've got to say, you're looking for a car, a used one, go to Manor Garages. I basically went to Evan Holshaw for my car and bought a brand new one. And not all of the people who work there are really bad. But I've got to say, I will never go to them again. I had the worst experience. So, I've been trying to sort the car out because it's got a little bit of a turbo problem at the moment.
Oh, a turbo problem?
That's what I found out the term was. It's not gone into limp mode, but I found out what limp mode meant today as well. It was a bit of a pain for me today, trying to get the car.
I guess normally put petrol in a car and it goes. I'm not very technically minded like that. I used to work at Manor Garage when
they
were on Manor Avenue.
What, do you know Bob?
Bob, is he the guy who lives on Park Road?
I think so. He's got a son called Sam.
The more easy going of the two.
Yeah.
Bob's all right. Is he the guy Ian?
Oh, I'm not sure.
Curly hair.
Oh, I've never met Ian.
Oh, no. Let's just say I worked there for a while.
I think it's a nice little garage, I've got to say. I'm very happy. I've got to say, it's female friendly as well. So, especially for people like me who's not too
Geared
up. So, yeah.
Okay, so folks, if you'd like to join in tonight, you can give us a call. The number you need is 07874055611, or have a word with us down in the comments on this video. We've got a little bit of new stuff lined up here tonight.
We certainly have.
Stay with us, keep watching, and all will be revealed.
It will indeed. So I'm just going to recap over a few things. Let me just get my notes together here. Before we go into our new little bit. Right, hang on, where's my photos? I've just got to go. Oh, here we go. Do you know what?
How many photos have you got on there?
Do you know what? They're all cats as well.
No, there's nothing wrong with that.
They're all my cats and all the dance stuff. So just recapping over things that we've done. If you remember my first live show, I was talking about Yvette Royal. Her track Run is due to release on the 30th of November. So that's like about, what's the date today? 20 seconds?
It's somewhere like that, yeah.
8 days' time. So that's, she's duetted with Michael Rice, finalist from X Factor, on that, Beneath You Beautiful, and she's got Run on this as well. So I'm going to find out where you can download that from because she hasn't actually let me know. So don't forget about that. That's going to be beautiful. And remember, she has got a live event at RUFC, the rugby club, and tickets are £20. Get them in advance. Just going on to other things. Just to recap you on the market, what's happening at Christmas. The Twilight Markets. The first one's going to be on December the 9th. Carol Singers, mulled wine, late night shopping, festive food. So that'll be great for everyone. They're also having another one on the 16th of December as well. I think that's Friday as well. And it's free to get in. Just remember the opening hours are 9 till 6 p.m. They're going to be open on Christmas Eve, close Christmas Day, Boxing Day, on New Year's Eve. If you're stuck for something to do, they're going to be open from 9 a.m. till 7:30 p.m. and they're going to be closed from 8:30 to 2 p.m. This is going to be a nice little New Year's Eve, bringing in New Year's Eve in the market with people, looking people and stuff. So I don't know if that's a free event. I've got to say I'm not sure yet. If you're interested, you can find out. You have Google. So go and have a look. Go and check it out if you want to go somewhere that's not like a mad club or anywhere. They'll have lots of entertainment though, so. Also, we've got something about the toy appeal, haven't we?
We have, yeah. The Key 103's Christmas toy appeal this year, one of the local drop-off points you will find at the railway in Hale.
Very good point.
Key Wales rerun this pretty much every year, as far as I'm aware. I'm not sure, sometimes Wilkinson's maybe, they're quite often drop-off point, but we know for sure that the railway in Hale is a drop-off point for this year's Key Wales re Christmas toy appeal. So please do what you can for these, for those kids who are not going to have such a Merry Christmas as would otherwise like.
Yeah. Can I just say, don't forget that it's not just the little kids as well, it's also teens. So they probably need a mixed age of things. So just have a think, especially like teenage boys. It's hard to buy for them,
like
I think.
Smellies and socks, isn't it, once you get past a certain age.
Yeah, or, you know, just things that we can use. Just, you know, maybe a nice top or a t-shirt or something.
Like a £20 note. I'm sure we could make use of
yeah.
that.
Oh God, definitely.
Hi, Chris Atkinson, by the way. Thanks for being there.
Hi, Chris.
As ever, Chris. How are you doing?
You're getting our Gold Star member award for like tuning in every time. We like Chris.
He needs to go on our Wall of Fame.
He does need to go. I think we need a Wall of Fame, to be honest. Quite good. Just going on as well about helping the homeless, as well, if anyone wants to donate to like homeless charities. I know... I was told by Homeless Action, well, Altrincham Homeless Action Group, they say that churches will take donations. Apparently they are distributing out to the homeless. And Skullfades Foundation Barbershop, next to the Marks and Spencers in Sale, collect and distribute your unwanted items. What people are looking for, I've found out, it's mainly coats for men. That's a real issue. There's a lack of warm clothing and coats and towels. So if you have old towels that you don't need, not like ripped up or anything, but just ones you don't use anymore, these charities need them, because when a lot of homeless people go, you know, they pay like a certain amount, or they go for a shower and get a hot meal, they get a shower but there's nothing to dry them on. And also if there is something to dry them on, they do take the towel with them. I mean, you would. So they need donations of towels, so they can at least give one out to people, and maybe soap as well, just little things for them. So that would be a nice touch. Don't forget your animal charities, please. That's a big thing of mine. Donate food and blankets. There's a particular charity on Dane Road as well, an animal sanctuary, that some little idiots decided to try and burn down not long ago. So they need as much help as you can get as well. So yeah, that's your update on your good deeds.
Okay, cool.
There you
so,
go.
So yeah, give all you can, please. Talking of Christmas, did you get to see the Christmas lights in Altrincham?
I saw them via Chris, actually, who did a really good job of filming ground. And I think he got a really good place from the top of the bridge overlooking balcony. There was some really good filming there, so I got to see the Star Wars characters press the button with Brooke Vincent, was it?
It was, yeah.
It was, and I think that was really exciting for everyone, so yeah.
Well, while Chris was at the top, I was downstairs in the crowd, and I just got lost.
Really?
I've never seen it so busy. Those Christmas lights are getting like the Gooseberry and Summer Festival,
yeah.
Just bigger and bigger every year.
That's great. That's right.
Next year it's going to be huge.
Some people don't like the Christmas lights. We've had a few comments that some people don't like them at all. I'd love to know what you want for the Christmas lights. What do you think the council could improve upon? I mean, I've got to say, I think the Christmas tree is fabulous. What I didn't like when Chris was filming the other day was the planter boxes being ripped up. That was absolutely appalling. I think everyone who saw that found that absolutely disgusting. I know I did. And I think we can't say who it was, because we have no proof of who it was. I suppose we have an idea of maybe who was to blame, but I think that's a really awful thing. You know, why do a few people have to spoil it for everyone else? It's not right. But I've got to say, that was some class filming that Chris actually got there and saw something happen there and then.
I know Chris was really upset about
yeah,
it as well,
as
a lot of people were,
yeah.
Rightly so, because Altrincham and Bloom was quite close to her heart.
Mm-hmm.
Because
we were both on the committee as well.
So yeah, it was a shame to see that, but...
Do they need donations at all for this?
Altrincham and Bloom are always after donations and volunteers. Mm. If you contact them via Facebook or Twitter, or you can email sarahw@raltrincham.org. They're always, always looking for volunteers. Mm. Incidentally, this Saturday in Barclays on George Street, Altrincham and Bloom are holding a bake sale. From 10 o'clock, I think it is. Get yourselves along there, support Altrincham and Bloom. It's in the warm this time rather than the stamp quarter. We'll be in the Barclays branch. Bring along your donations of cakes and help us help Altrincham and Bloom. Make Altrincham blooming.
Yeah, honestly, I walked past some planters today and they're absolutely stunning. I was near Rhode Island coffee shop actually, I went for coffee with a friend. And I just thought they were beautiful, and I told her about what had happened with planters on the Stamford Quarter, and I think we're all in a bit of shock. And I've got to say, if you know who did that, or, you know, if it was your child, you really should be ashamed of yourself for having out at that time on Sunday night for a start, and I'd actually bring them and make them do a little bit of work on that planter, to be honest. Just teach them that they can't do that. Anyway, that's the rant over.
Hi to Rach, by the way, who's joined us. Not seen you for a little while, Rach.
Hi there.
Thanks for being there.
Oh.
Hi, Rach.
Right, so we've got a new little section coming up now.
We have, yeah.
We've got the Agony Aunt and Uncle section. And I put a post on today to say, you know, if you want to email us in with your issues, you can do. They can be anonymous. Don't put your name, or just put please keep my name anonymous. And email us. And we've actually been inundated with these. These are quite... I've had a little glance through, but we're just going to read them off the cuff. Now, we are not professional psychologists or anything like that, but we're going to give you our opinion. And that's all that matters.
We think we're well-rounded people of the world, don't we?
We're going to give it a go.
Why not?
We might give some bad advice, we might give some good advice. We'd also love to know what you would do as well, watchers. So feel free to comment on these. Andy, I'm going to ask you to go first on these.
Okay. All right. Well, I will just read this as it says here.
Okay.
Hi, Kate and Andy. I've recently fallen out with someone I thought was my friend. I've told her personal things about myself that I found out she has told other people when I told her not to. I feel very hurt she has gone behind my back, and now she has spread rumours about me at work that I'm a slag.
That's bloody horrible.
I feel like quitting my job and running away. My other friends are not really the kind of people who I can talk to. They don't really care about personal stuff. How can this girl be saying stuff about me? Is that your typo? How can I, this girl, saying stuff about
me? Well, I did copy and paste them all, so I'm sorry if I've got that wrong.
I think you mean, how can you stop this girl saying stuff about me?
Yeah, if you mean that, I am sorry. I think that might be the way she's written it, so... I don't think
you can't fight it, really, can you?
You can't stop people saying things about you, that's the thing. You need to be careful who you trust. But then it boils down to the point, I personally think it boils down to the point, you need to choose your friends wisely as well. And I think maybe just a few close friends are more important than having a massive group of friends, especially if they're backstabbing. I'm just looking at the fact that you say your other friends, you can't really talk to them. So are they more like acquaintances?
Work colleagues, probably.
Yeah.
It's not the same as having that close friend.
I don't know, that's a really hard one. I'd actually just find some new friends. Listen, there's a group called Meetup. Go on there. Go to groups, meet some proper friends, seriously. I'd cut that girl out of my life just like that. I wouldn't have anyone saying stuff about me. I wouldn't react to it. That's the worst possible thing you can do. If you react to it, someone's going to go, oh, she's got something to hide. If you've got family, you can talk to your family and ask them. That might be the right thing.
I think so. Or just ignore it. Because
yeah.
the reality is that whether you know about it or not, if they're going to do that, they're going to do it behind your back anyway. So why let it worry you?
Yeah, do you know what? There's worse things.
Rise
being
above
called.
It.
She might be just a bit jealous.
Yeah. Rise above it.
Ignore her. Who's that from?
M.O.
M.O.
That's our best advice on
that's
that one.
Yeah. Right, I've got one. Dear Agony Aunt. I'm going to put Agony Aunt and Uncle here. I'm going to vote to work for us. My partner is under a lot of pressure at work and has been taking his stresses out on me. This has included being verbally aggressive to me and the children and often putting me down. He's uncooperative when I ask for help or do anything in the house with the family. Everything I say or do he disagrees with, which is starting to make me unhappy and angry and affecting my mental well-being. I don't want to split up, but I feel I'm in a no-win situation. That's from Helen. Ooh.
Mm.
Sorry to hear that. He's under a lot of pressure at work. It doesn't mean it's okay to take things out on you. It does happen, though. They say that people are harsher to the people they love the most, but it doesn't mean it's okay. I mean, ideally, I don't know, you've got children.
Yeah.
When you come home, I mean, surely you want to be, you want your family around with you and all that.
Yeah, well, I've always taken the view that if one parent is angry, annoyed with a kid, then I don't think it's right for both parents, regardless of what they're doing, for both of them. The kids have got to have somebody who they can go to.
Yeah,
so.
I think so. It is, I mean, you don't want to split up, but you feel you're in a no-win situation. Have you tried counselling, maybe, or just making some time for both of you, sitting down and talking calmly? I know it's harder than it, you know, just saying it.
It's surprising what you can get out of sitting down and having a proper heart-to-heart talk if you approach it properly.
Yeah, and you need to find out, do you both still want this? It doesn't actually say if you're married or if you're just together, but do you still want this relationship? And also you've got to think about kids as well. If he's being verbally aggressive to you, I mean that's just, it's gonna really, it does affect someone, it affects the confidence a lot. It's not nice people being nasty, you know. And it's like that to the children. I'd sit him down and just say, do you realise this is what you're doing?
Yeah.
And just say, I'm not picking on you, but I feel, don't blame him, but just say, I feel maybe that we need to spend time as a family and get together again as a family unit, because we're drifting away from each other and I don't want that. You obviously don't want to split up, so yeah.
Perhaps he's not particularly aware of what he's actually doing.
Yeah, that's a sad one. That's really sad.
Can I just go back to that first one as well?
Of course.
Rach here is saying, with regards to the lady who was asking for advice, Rach says she needs to confront the person spreading rumours and rise above it. If it involves a job, then maybe let the boss know.
Yeah, or go to HR as well, the HR department, if they do have one. That's good advice, Rach.
Yeah, thank you for that.
If she's confident enough to confront her, do it.
Yeah.
But keep it civil. You don't want to let your emotions get in the way and then end up in a slanging match. But yeah, good advice. You can comment again, Rachel. You're next.
Okay, another one.
Yeah.
I want to propose to my girlfriend on Christmas Day, but all her family will be there. We're going to their house for Christmas dinner, but her dad doesn't really like me. I'm 22, work full time, and love my girlfriend to bits. How can I do this without her dad knowing or killing me? I think dad's going to find out.
Yeah, there's no way around this. I wonder how long you've been with this girl, first of all. 22 is really young. Make sure you know what you're doing. That's my biggest advice for you. Depending on how long you've been together, I've had friends that have been together since, you know, childhood sweethearts, and then they've got married in the 20s and stuff. Just really consider what you're doing, because it's a young age to get married.
Is she expecting a proposal? Maybe clue her in a little bit. That might give you an idea.
Yeah, I mean, have you discussed anything about marriage? I mean, I'm not saying 22 is the wrong age to get married or anything. It works for a lot of people. I've got to say, I have literally ran away. I was proposed to a few times, and I ran, kicking and screaming to the hills, because I thought, I want my life. I'm not saying I don't want to get married, I really do, but I don't, you know, that was too young for me. So really make sure your girlfriend is ready for that. As for the dad, yeah, if he doesn't like you now, mate, you're going to have to prove something to him. You're going to have to prove that you're worthy of his daughter. I wonder why he doesn't like you. You haven't given much information there. He might just be very protective.
He's probably just looking after his daughter.
Yeah. So. What would you do if it's your child and she was like quite young and...
So long as she knew what she was doing and it's what she wanted, she was happy and he was a decent kid, then...
He sounds really nice, actually. He loves his girlfriend. He's got a full-time job. He obviously wants to support her. You know what? Buy the dad something nice for Christmas, and even if he doesn't accept
it, keep him sweet.
Even if he doesn't go thank you or anything, it doesn't matter. You've been the bigger person.
You've made an effort.
Yeah. So thank you.
I hope that goes well.
It's anonymous.
Anonymous.
Thank you, Anonymous, for that one. Right, let me go back into mine. I don't think we're going to have time to read all these out. We might have to come back to this.
Okay.
Here's one. My friend told me she's having an affair with someone we both know. I feel like his wife has a right to know what is going on, and I don't feel comfortable keeping it a secret. I wish she hadn't told me. She thinks she's in love with this man, even though he's someone else's husband. I'm not sure what to do, as I don't want to ruin her friendship, ruin our friendship, or make her unhappy. Ooh! First of all, having an affair with someone, that's dodgy territory. You got to think, why are people having affairs in the first place? You either work on your relationship or you get out. Don't be having an affair.
It suggests that something's not right, isn't it?
Something isn't right if the guy is having an affair. I wouldn't feel comfortable. I know someone at the moment who's basically doing something very similar, and I have no time for that person, really. I think it's very nice. His wife might have a right to know, but that means you're the messenger. You know what happens to messengers? They usually get shot. If you don't feel comfortable keeping it a secret, I would walk away from that situation. I would just say, tell her I don't feel comfortable with it. I know too much. I don't want to know anymore. It's a hard situation. You've been dragged into something. You're going to have to consider this carefully. You don't want to ruin the friendship, but...
It's a tricky one, isn't it? The reality is you have to do what's best.
Yeah.
Because otherwise it's not going to carry on.
Yeah. You need to just advise your friends that it's the wrong thing that she's doing here. She might be in love with a guy, but there's plenty of other people out there. You don't go having affairs with people. Even if you think they're going to leave them, and even if they're promising you the world. It's very rare it works out well, from what I've seen from silly people who've done it. I wouldn't touch that one with a barge pole. I'd say, I'll be your friend, but I don't want to know anymore, because I know this person. Whether you want to tell his wife, think about what that reaction's going to be. Because she could turn around on you and say it's a lie, you could lose their friendship. Or you could just walk away right now and not say anything. You need to consider all these options, what if situations.
Yeah.
I think that's the best one.
I think we'll stick with that.
Ooh.
We've actually got another one here in a similar sort of vein from Tasha. I have a boyfriend, but I got drunk on Saturday night and sent naked pics to one of his besties.
Why?
He went mad and didn't believe me when I said the cat sat on my phone and sent a pic to his mate by accident. How can I make him believe me? Well, Tasha, I have to say, on the face of it, that made me think, these things do happen, I suppose.
What? I'm sorry, your cat sent you a picture. Did you really say that? I'm sorry to laugh, but that is quite funny. I'm sorry, your cat sat on your phone and sent a naked picture of you.
What were you going to do with these naked pictures in the first place? Why were they on your phone?
You could have said that you took them for him. But, oh God, no. Right, first thing, do not send naked pictures of yourself to anyone in any regards. If you're with someone and you think it's going to be a lasting relationship, those things can end up going to other people and on the internet. It's a really stupid thing to do. It's what kids are doing nowadays. Oh, how old's this girl, did she say?
I don't know, it doesn't say.
She's young.
It sounds like it.
Just, you're going to have to come clean. I was thinking honesty is the best policy. Come clean and just say, I got drunk. Did you mean to send it? Who did she mean to send it to? Did you send it by accident to his best mate? Thinking it was your boyfriend?
It sounds as though the cat sent them by accident and she had no intention of sending them anywhere.
Right.
But for personal reference, by the sounds of it.
Well, you know, I suppose everyone does make mistakes, but your boyfriend's going to be pretty mad at the moment if you're sending naked pictures of yourself around. Unless he's a very open-minded, liberal person, he doesn't sound happy. I would just come clean and say, I'm really sorry, it will never happen again. And just hope for the best.
I'll put the cat in a box.
Yeah.
Keep it in a box.
Yeah. Stop giving your phone to the cat. get pictures of its bum sent to you.
I think maybe we could squeeze one more in.
Let's squeeze one more in.
Would you like to do another one?
Let's have another one. I'm worried. Who's this from? This is from Kathy. I'm worried about the amount of time my daughter spends on social media and what she's doing and who she's speaking to. She is 13 and will not tell me anything and spends most of her time staring at her phone in private. I cannot physically take her phone off her at night. Yes, you can. So end up going to bed. Hang on, what's she put there? I cannot physically take her phone off her at night, so end up going to bed and she stays up for hours on a school night looking at her phone. I'm worried she's doing things she shouldn't even, though I trust her to be sensible. Kathy, I'm not being funny, but this girl, like, this is all children right now. Remember, they are in your house. You pay for them up to the age of 18, usually, sometimes beyond. You have rights to do things as a parent. Fine, it's not nice taking things off children. But you can control what she does. She's 13 years old. She's a child, and you need to protect this. You need to protect her. I'm going off what my mum would do. I would not even be allowed. If my parents didn't trust me, my phone would be like, you give it here, you'll get it back in the morning for school. And then you give it back at night. You don't spend all your time on social media. Because it's now got to a generation where kids and people are just like that all the time.
But it's normal for them, isn't it?
It is normal, and it's quite sad because they don't learn other social skills and other, like, how to talk to each other. Or it's really sad. I'd actually possibly. It's a hard one. I'd maybe just say, right, you've got between the hours of this and that to chat to your friends. But as she's 13, she can have a Facebook account, but you should be able to control what she does see and what she doesn't see. You can also go on Facebook and control what you see her doing as well. I'm sure there's ways to do that. But there's no way I would, if it was me, I would let my daughter go, I'm doing what I want. I'd say, no, you're not. Do you pay for the phone contract?
More than likely.
Yeah. Really? No, don't let her walk over you like that. I don't know, what do you think?
Well, being a parent, of course, it's you have the serious things to think of, like school the next morning, simple things like that. You've got to be up for school, you've got to be fresh. Why aren't you doing your homework instead of on your phone?
Yeah. And you've got to be careful of people these days who are grooming kids.
Yeah.
There is a lot of this about. You need to see who's on her phone. You need to see what she's on, if she's on Snapchat. Because people can sell, if we're going back to sending naked photos to people, kids do this now. They look at the internet of, like, all these famous Kardashians or whatever, and they see photos of them, like, with the bums hanging out and everything, and they try and emulate that. And these kids do not have the PR companies to kind of make them look good while they're doing it or control what happens on media. These are vulnerable children, so, yeah, take a stand and don't be afraid to do that. Just remember, you want the best for your kids. even if it is taking a hard line, I think that's the right way about that.
Sound advice, I think. Sound advice?
Yeah. I'm sorry that we didn't get through everyone's problems tonight. We will go back on those next Wednesday. We'll have some more of this.
Yeah.
Okay, so a bit of time. If you want to email in the meantime, we will put posts up, but it is kate@altringhamnews.
altringham.news.com.
No, is it not .com?
No, it's kate@altringham.news.
I am so sorry. Kate.
The new girl.
@altringham.news. Sorry.
That'll get straight to Kate. You can also email me, andy@altringham.news. You can email any of the team, just stick the name in the front there.
Yeah, joe@altringham.news, chris@altringham.news.
It'll find a way to. And talking of Chris, watch out for a live tomorrow evening from Chris. Behind the camera there, what time are we having a live tomorrow?
I'd say about 7:30.
At 7:30, Chris will be doing a little bit of a walk around Altrincham before our fortnightly Altrincham and Bloom meeting. Looking forward to that tomorrow, see what Sarah says about all that damage to the plants.
Be happy. Sarah, if you're watching, I've got to say, I think the whole of Altrincham who saw that were disgusted. So with any luck, you will get some donations and help for that, and we really hope some will appeal to you to do that as well. Just the amount of time people have put in, it's pretty awful.
So watch out for Chris from 7:30. Kate and myself will be back here next Wednesday, 8:30.
Yeah.
Watch out for the other lives Sunday. They could pop up They could pop up anywhere as we... We're always looking at new ideas and things to do. We're looking for your help on that. Any ideas, anything you'd like to see, please get in touch, let us know what you'd like to see on from the news doing.
I think we'd like to support everyone. Well, we'd like to thank everyone for their good support of the Altrincham News team as well. We always like nice people supporting us.
We do.
Yeah,
because we're nice people ourselves.
We are.
But we like to think so anyway.
People who drag you down for no reason.
No.
But the nice people, we thank you for your support, and we'll be here next week. Chris will be with you tomorrow from 7:30. And I think we're done for this evening.
Yeah. So, take care out there, Altrincham.
Keep safe, keep warm.
And we will see you soon.
Take care.